If you saw it on a store shelf, you might not have any idea how some people are using it. Law enforcement says this is synthetic marijuana, commonly known as K2 or spice, and made by various companies.
Companies and kids are experimenting with this stuff, and it's becoming quite scary.
K2 is sold as an herbal incense that clearly states on the package, not for human consumption. But police say people are misusing it to get high, leading to hallucinations, fast heartbeats, and more.
Agitated behavior, nausea, vomiting, that type of reaction to it.
In other states, synthetic marijuana is being investigated in connection with some deaths and suicides. And in Wisconsin, Charlie Gable's family believes it led to his fatal car crash. Locally, in at least 4 incidents in the towns of Jaffrey and Ringe, police believe K2 incense helped cause serious mental breakdowns and medical calls. In one instance, in Jaffrey in September, the police chief says a parent took her son to the hospital with an extremely high pulse. She told police she could physically see his heart beating when looking at his chest. Police say the teen admitted to smoking K2. Because the active ingredient, JWH-018, is synthetic and so new, it's unregulated in New Hampshire. One juvenile detective in Manchester says kids as young as middle school are talking about it.
It's readily available. You can buy it online, you can buy it in a smoke shop.
In fact, we had no trouble finding it online or at local stores around the state. And you don't always have to be 18 to buy this stuff. Franklin town officials are so concerned, they are now drafting an ordinance to ban the substance in town.
What people are going to do is try to sell it as much and as often as they can until such time as it becomes regulated.
There is also a new bill in Concord to ban K2 or spice statewide. The Attorney General's office is closely studying a growing number of bans around the country.
I think the concern here is that these substances are not appropriate for human consumption or safe.
New Hampshire would hardly be alone. Already 13 states and the U.S. military have banned forms of synthetic marijuana. But not everyone is on board.
We're the only herbal incense company that has come out to talk to the media.
Rick Broider runs a local herbal incense company and says most manufacturers don't want to talk about the incense.
The majority of all of our products are grown right here in New Hampshire.
As you might expect, Broider opposes a ban, defending the product as a tool to relax. People who smoke it or misuse it, he says, need to be better educated.
It's not much different than if you were to go to a bridge that says no diving and dive off a bridge, you're probably going to get unintended consequences.
Rick says his incense has not led to any injuries, and he believes it should only be sold to adults. While he won't say exactly what's in his product, he compares it to other legal substances.
You can use alcohol, you know, you can utilize tobacco, or you can utilize incense and create a relaxing environment for yourself.
While many local store owners didn't want to talk about the herbal incense products, we found one who did.
We're going to do the right thing. And I wrestle with carrying this product in my store.
Walter runs the store in Allenstown, where there have been numerous requests for K2. He decided not to sell it because he says most manufacturers he's dealt with are secretive about how they make the product.
We don't want to offer our customers anything that we don't know what it is, we don't know where it comes from.
Walter does sell one herbal incense product with the ingredients listed on the package. It's limited to people 18 and over. While he may be torn, he's willing to follow the market demand as long as it's legal.
But you still sell it?
I still sell it.
Yeah.
My customers want it. I don't want it. My customers choose what we sell in the store. That's been our claim to fame since we opened a year ago.
We did try to contact the maker of the K2 we purchased, but did not get a call back. While some dispute just how dangerous synthetic marijuana is, it is prompting a number of medical calls. The American Association of Poison Control Centers says in the last year, there have been more than 2,000 calls related to synthetic marijuana nationwide. I'm Sean McDonald, WMUR News 9.